finish the rest of the Ozark Highlands Trail, going to Woolum, starting there, doing all the little segments and whatnot, including the like 13-mile bushwhack that's in between Highway 14 and Spring Creek Trailhead for the Sillimore section of the OHT. Anyways, I'm going to end at Matney Knob. I'm not going all the way to Norfolk Dam, doing that little 13-mile section by the lake. It's like 79 miles, I think, maybe 80 miles, somewhere around in there. There's no telling how long it's actually going to be, considering there's a bushwhack in there. Anyway, stoked, way stoked, super excited, trying out some new stuffs, some new clothes. It's going to be my first time sleeping on the ground. I got my Gossamer gear, the little 1/8-inch foam pad, same Cooper fiber, my hammock tarp. Set it up with my trekking poles, Polycrow for a ground cloth. I got the simple pack. The rest is pretty standard. Not even taking a cold soaking pot this time. No cook, no soak. Just eat it when you want it. So have a feeling I'm going to like it that way. And it'll also make Thanksgiving dinner so much better. Anyway, heading down the road, getting to Arkansas. You just sunrise. Coming down the road to Woolum. There's two roads into Woolum, 15 and 14. I'm coming down 14, hit a road closed sign. Some folks that I'm like, yo man, it's 15 open. We're like, actually, you can just take a right up here and go down this really sketchy four-wheel drive road and get over to 15. And I was like, all right, bet. That sucked. Camera's off the top of my truck. And we're off. Starting out. Great day. Overcast, a little damp, misty kind of stuff. Mom just drove me across the river. Bye, Mom. Anyways, I'm gonna cross Richland Creek and go find the Buffalo River Trail over on the other side to get started on this escapade. Day one, mile one, 79er. A little bit chilly, airish. See a nice dry spot up ahead. I can get across Richland. Here's Richland. It's a big pool just before it hits the Buffalo. Down there. Mom drove me across the Buffalo. A little closer to the trail and not have to cross the bigger river and get my feet wet. Thanks, Mom. Dry spot. Right up here. Gonna get across and get on down. I need to get my gear more dialed in. 21 pounds right now. And that's with no water. No hip belt on the Palante pack, simple pack. No hip belt, a little heavy at 21 pounds with 6 days of food in it. Speaking of water, I need to get some. Water time. Now you go find the trail. Holla. Found it, the trail that is. So yay, we're on trail. Stoked. I've been stoked all day. Guess what? I'm still stoked.
You know those buttresses that I always yap about in my floating videos?
Buttress.
It's a buttress. I'm on top of one now.
Lay Branch Cemetery. Almost to Slay Branch. Hopefully there's some water in Slay Branch because I'm about out.
Well, if I really wanted it, there's a big old puddle right there.
Oh, there's Slay Branch right there. Let's go see.
Puddle water.
Came out okay. It was very green, brown, not good looking. Ran it through the bandana, had it iron, be free, and here we are. Water. Let's see what it tastes like. Water. Tastes like water. Okay, back to the truck. Awesome. Well, this is a pretty nice spot. Cleared off.
Good tent site for my first go around with the tent, I believe.
I've got a pretty good view.
I'm going to get my tent set up. Let's see how that goes. Y'all wanna watch? Watch this. Let's see. Let's see how that goes.
This is my hammock tarp, same one, the Cuban fiber cat cut from Hammock Gear, but it makes for a big old spacey home. Doors actually can close all the way off. It's got ventilation, obviously, because of the cat cut. Kind of flaps around a little bit. Could probably fix that if I tension this out, but don't worry about all that. Anyways, got this set up. I'm gonna get my pad laid down, my polycrow and all that stuff. Then I'm gonna have dinner. Peace. Good night to you. I will see you in the morning. Bye. Holla. Hitting the trail. Bright and early. Only got 10 hours or so of sunlight each day, so I'm having to get going early. I can make miles. Anyways, holla. See you then, sir. Peace. Peter Cave Road we have here. Too shabby up here. Tire tracks going down the middle of it. We're at a ford. I don't remember the name of it. Anyways, no water here, but just a minute ago, I passed a spring that was coming out of the bottom of a little bluff. I was on top of it, but there's easy access to it. So I'm going back to that spring. Spring, bottom of bluff. Comes out, runs down, goes into that place that we were
at the ford of a second ago. Bad with words. Holla, get in the water. Come across this nice old home site. Just up here from that field. Small storage or of sorts. There and there. A house and the nice fence. Goes through a tunnel under Highway 65. Anyways, pretty cool, pretty awesome. Okay, that's Dillard's Ferry. I was stopped by. I went to the bathroom, and lo and behold, in the pack your trash out area, there was a trash can. I gotta dump all my trash. That's awesome. Anyways, alright. Back at it. On the trail. Still got like 12 to 13 to do today. We'll see. Here we go. Buffalo River Trail. And actually, shout outs, what's that guy's name? I'll put a link to his website in the description below. According to all NPS stuff that I can find, this part of the trail does not exist. Maybe it is on this website somewhere, but as far as I can find, this part of the trail doesn't exist. But I did find a map of it on this guy's site. So I have a map, and I know it's here. So, yay, here it is. And there's an old home site or old building of some sort. Okay. Pretty cool. I've passed so many remnants of old stuff today. Like that. There's the front end of an old car. Passed that old car yesterday. Anyways, I'm gonna stop yabbing. Hike. Holla. Peace. Wind is shifting now, and it's starting to get cold. Just like that. It's supposed to be a gnarly front blow through like 40 mile an hour winds or stuff. This is cool. I think this is called Illinois Point. Damn, I just stepped on a snake. Legit just stepped on that.
It's the middle of November. What are you doing out, bro?
Holy shit.
Watch out, people.
He's docile. He's not moving much. Real chill. Anyways, I think this is an Illinois Point. I'm about to lose my hat. It's a nice view. And that's Gilbert. The town of Gilbert over there. Eventually, I'll be up on the next... There went my hat. Eventually, I'll be up on the next mountain over. And I'll be at Gilbert Overlook. Apparently, I reckon there's a good overlook of it. Anyways, we'll keep moving. Keep moving. Woo! Watch out for snakes, y'all. Middle of November. They on the trail. When Quint and I floated the whole buffalo, we stopped in there and got a pulled pork sandwich on a pickle. They really pushed the pickles for a pulled pork sandwich down there at the little general store. Anyway, that's cool. Seeing Gilbert from this angle.
Oh, shout out to Johnny. Johnny lives down there. Johnny, I don't know if you watch my stuff, but shout out, bro. What's up? Anyways,
who puts an old washing machine in the middle of the trail?
Seriously, it's kind of cool.
I like it.
Literally, just in the middle of the trail. Here we go.
Of all the places on this creek I've done seen back downstream that I could have got across, the trail takes me to here. There's the trail, straight across. Look at this spot. Nothing but a buttload of water. That's it. So, I think I'm gonna go shoes wet and pull the pants up. I don't wanna test the pants today. Temperature's steadily dropping, so be okay with cold, wet shoes. And that's what you get trail runners for anyways. Here we go. Walk through the water. See you down trail.
Look at there. That's where I crossed that creek a minute ago. Now I'm up here. The map said there was a view up here. It wasn't lying. It's getting cold. I got my next layer on, mid layer. I tried to wear this as my base layer yesterday. The wool was eating into my shoulders, man. It was chafing me pretty good. It's great as a mid layer, but I don't know about a base layer, not with the pack on. The pants are great. The bottom of my pants got wet coming across, gone like maybe a half mile uphill from crossing that river. So they're already dry. I think it's a cotton nylon blend. G1000 is what they call it. The Fall Raven company. It's tough, I tell you that. Kicking through some briars, and they're comfy pants too. The vents are really nice. Not sponsored. Oh wait, there's that view. Apparently there's like an overlook out there. Let's go see it. Doing all this on 1% battery, by the way. Look at the view. Was gonna get water from that. Nope. This is the old train track. The train trestles across the buffalo are that way, and the train trestles across this is right here. Pretty cool. Still on 1% battery. This may cut off, but I'm gonna try to get these cows. Cows.
Oh, cow. Baby cow. Baby cow.
The trail is cool too. Back to the trail. Check out these woods. Good woods. And there's the Tatonka. Day 2 of
6 days. And my bag's leaking.
May have to go try and holler at an outpost if I can catch a ride somewhere. Anyways, I gotta go find camp.
It's getting dark. Well, it'll be getting dark soon.
Got cold overnight last night, down in the 30s. Got the fog going over there, just like flowing down the river. Anyways, I had to get up, bust, move early this morning because my water filter, Catadine Be Free, the bag busted on it. There's a seal where it kind of, the bag kind of seals around the harder plastic. That seam busted, so now I have no way of filtering water. I still got at least probably 15 miles to go before I get to a road that I could potentially get to a store that might have water treatment. Probably don't have water treatment. It is what it is. If I can get something to treat my water, I'm gonna keep going. If not, I may have to end it at the next highway, so we'll see. We'll watch this fog move a little bit more, and then I'm gonna get on down the trail. Peace. Get some water a second ago. Tried duct taping. Filter didn't work. I'm so ill on having a water filter. Unless I can get to Wild Bill's Outfitter and they have something. We'll see. Also, I was just in the process of getting water. I had a hunter come up.
He's like, man, you need to be wearing some orange.
I was like, I am wearing orange. My hat.
He says, yeah, I see it.
Okay.
I'm out here tracking one of your deer, see you come around the corner in your brown jacket.
Not brown, it's curry. Anyways.
So here I am getting ready to shoot, and I realize you got an orange hat on.
Glad you realized I had an orange hat on.
He said, well, hell yeah, me too. He said, it's state law, man. You gotta be wearing that orange.
I guess I'm unfamiliar with the law that you have to be wearing so much orange to be legal if you're backpacking and not hunting.
He said, look, man, I'm not trying to jump your ass. I'm just saying.
I'm from Mississippi. I don't know that you even have a law that says you're supposed to wear so much orange. And I'm out here backpacking on a backpacking trail, not a hunting trail.
This is a WMA. There's a lot of hunters out here hunting. So, man, you ought to think about wearing some orange.
Okay, man, thanks. I'm wearing orange. So now I'm cold. Took my curry jacket off. Hopefully there's no gray deer running around in the woods. Anyways. I'll let you know what I'm gonna do about a water filter. Goodbye. Beavers. Spring Creek. Beavers made a dam on Spring Creek. I gotta try to find the trail. I don't think I'm on the trail. I realized I crossed too early, so I came back across. I got my foot wet. That one. Sucks. Now I got a wet foot. Now I gotta cross the creek again. There's some rocks though.
See if I can make this.
Made it. Here we go. Blaze on the big tree. So, fun fact. I'm on my way up to a Spring Creek Bluff right now. Once I reach Spring Creek Bluff, I will have successfully completed all of the Buffalo River Trail. Every single mile of it. Including stuff that's not even on the map yet. So, yeah, accomplishments. Hashtag goals. Pretty cool. Anyways. We'll be right back.
one success.
I made it to Spring Creek Bluff. You saw. I've successfully completed, hiked every mile of Buffalo River Trail. I'm now on a repeated section. That last little bit that I just did from Woolum down to Spring Creek Bluff was the last bit that I had never done. So, yay. Stoked for that. Mark that off my list. You can probably tell from the videos that I put out, I like this place. I come here a good bit. You should try it out sometime. It's an awesome place. Good views, wildlife, wildflowers during spring are good. Lots of ferns, hardwood forests. River is awesome. Waters are clear, crystal clear. It's nice. It's a beautiful place. Try it out sometime. I can vouch for it. I've seen all the trail. I guarantee you. It's good stuff. Drew a smiley face on this blaze like 3 years ago. There's the mouth. The eyes are gone.
Smiley.
So cool. It may have been more than 3 years ago. 3-4 years ago, something like that. Cool. Strong hammock up here. It's up in there somewhere. Kimball Bluff. Kimball Bluff view. Nice. I'm gonna chill a second and then head on. I got about 2 miles left. Well, I'm almost there. Highway 14. I can hear traffic. There's a rock. Mom's bringing me a water filter. I happened to have service. I called her. And it just so happened to work out that I would be hitting Highway 14 right at about the time that she could get to Highway 14 with the water filter. So, that's what we're doing. Thanks, Mom. Anyways, I'm going to get my filter. Get something to drink. And push on.